Here we go. Oh crap, I forgot to put this on YouTube. Oh well. Forgot to stream this to YouTube as well. Hello, Pori. This should work very well now. Hopefully, as long as graphic texture stuff doesn't go missing or whatever. But speed-wise, it'll work perfectly. Ray, this is Yoshino Takigawa's diary. They asked me to take care of it at the hospital, since her family were all killed in the accident. He didn't seem to feel comfortable keeping it around the hospital. Was I right to accept it? I mean, it can't hurt. I heard it's good for the heart to write in a diary and have someone read it. By doing this, maybe I will stop seeing that terrible dream. I'm sad being all alone. If I can have someone read this in some way, maybe I will connect with them. My family and Nalia died, but being alone is more frightening than even that harsh fact. More than the accident itself, being the only one living afterwards, waiting endlessly, that was more frightening. Left all alone in the total darkness, a sweltering night but freezing cold. I had a nasty dream. Snow fell at an old abandoned house. I'm all alone and lost, but they might all be in that house. I can meet them. I sense that. If I go in, I can meet them. They're calling me, but if I go in, I may not be able to return. But if that's what he wants... Bit by bit, I go in deeper. I'm cold. It's getting dark. I can hear a song. Naoya's in there. Mom, Dad, everyone besides me, all in there. They all left me behind, left me and went in, because only I survived. It's painful. Is the pain the dream? The tattoo spreads. The doctor says he can't see anything. Overseas, they apparently call emotional trauma after an accident like this PTSD, but I can see it. After sleeping several days, I'm only half awake. Gradually, I come not to know whether I'm awake or asleep. The doctor seemed interested when he listened to my story. Maybe he is becoming more sympathetic. But that dream and the pain are mine alone. The pain is spreading. Am I to blame, since I'm the only one who survived? But it's not like I chose to survive. It hurts. It hurts. It hurts. What should I do? What? Forgive me. That woman is coming after me. I can see her even when I'm awake. I can't take being touched again. I don't want to see anymore. Sounds traumatic. How are you, Pori? About the photo you gave me. There are marks on her. Don't you think they look like tattoos? I dream like 6 times a night, up to 6 times a night, so I know quite clearly the difference between dream and waking nowadays, even if it's hard to tell the difference sometimes while you're dreaming. It is my favorite color. I keep missing the environmental details because I'm scrolling through way too fast. This game has a lot of environmental details, and similar to Parasite Eve 2. And it also has pretty good characterization of Rei. On the shelf is a camera I never use anymore. I used to enjoy using this camera back in the days when I used to take pictures for fun. On this shelf, I keep my photo books and newspapers. Miku bought most of the photography books for me. She has a good eye for these things, but most of them I've hardly even glanced at. My clothes are thrown carelessly into the closet. I've never been a tidy person, and unless I make a real effort, things soon get like this. Miku must not have been in here yet. She would never have left it in this state. There are several handmade scented candles on top of the desk. Miku made them. She probably made them specially with me in mind, but for that reason I can't bring myself to light them. And so they just sit here, unlit and unused. On the desk are a sketchbook and an appointment book Miku made for me to keep track of all my work assignments. Squeezed into the corner of the page is a handwritten warning. Don't work too hard. Maybe I have been working too hard since that day, but that's the way I prefer it right now. That's how you squelch trauma. It's not a good idea, but it works. Keeps you from feeling and keeps you from thinking. Is this that place from yesterday? Yep, the speed is working well. This is closed now. Oh, hello! You're really good at sneaking up on me, aren't you? Man, I'm doing a lot worse than I used to at this. Screwing around anymore. Oh, cool, I saw that coming. Doing really bad. That went well. Well, that's a lot of film, though. I should have gone for her from the start. I'll remember that for next time. I think she woke from her dream, dude. Wait a second. Ah, okay. I see. Easy peasy. I'm not saving because I did horrible on Yoshino. This upcoming area scares the crap out of me. Looks like a tree root. Hall of Shadows. Hall with shadows bleeding through the walls. The ghosts are moaning. The graveyard from Ray's dream.
I remember now. I remember this place.
No, I missed it. I was so close. Daydream, you was in here.
Thank you.
That was an accident. After being called into a dream, a woman who threw herself off a roof. So that woman was called into a dream, into this dream manner. She was dreaming and she threw herself off the roof. Pleasant. So it's possible to go down there, I believe. Whoops, wrong button. Come here, dork. Oh, showing off a little too much. Okay, let's try again. You can hear the hammering of stakes in the background. Oh, I missed that shot. Cool. I haven't played this in like 13 years. But I still remember it very well. Well, I don't remember it that well. There's some things I've forgotten. some things I don't remember where they're at. You there, Pori? I'm gonna stop and have dinner now. And maybe some ice cream. Thank you for joining me. See you guys around.